Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Dr. Claudia Albers, Planet X Research and Professional Physicist. And today I'd like to bring to you another one of my articles. This one is entitled NASA and Planet X Disclosure and the Great Deception. As I have shown in several articles regarding NASA, they seem to fake everything they do, as well as do it in such a way that it is disclosed that it is fake. For example, they go to the trouble of supposedly filming astronauts on the ISS for years and then leak a photograph which clearly indicates that these are actors in a set on Earth. And you can see here, it looks like a photograph of astronauts on the ISS. Notice that their shirts have been purposely pulled up in order to make it appear that they are in zero gravity. Also, all of them are holding on to something, but yet the window was left open. So these are not astronauts training on an ISS simulator. They are clearly doing everything possible to act as if they are in space. And the raised shirts suggest that they may be held up with fishing wire. So they wouldn't do that for people in training because that would stop them from moving. So this is obviously fake. So in Article 411, entitled Connection Between NASA and the Secret Space Program, you may find some more details on this. They also reportedly launch a mission to Mars to land a new Mars rover, but made it obvious that it is fake because the mission control specialists they use do not behave like mission control specialists at all, but rather like actors. And you can see here from these two screenshots, you can see this man making surprise facial expressions as the probe was being reported to be about to land, seemed to go out of his way to portray a feeling that the landing might go wrong, and then show this elation as it apparently landed with his full body. This is not how you'd expect a technical specialist concentrating on his job to act. This is how you would expect an actor to act in the absence of any ability to show any actual data pertaining to an actual landing on Mars. This seems to be the action of an actor, not a technical person. And you may look at Article 463 entitled On NASA Mars Missions Real. In addition, they use images of Mars which show pools of water on the ground, which could therefore only have been taken on Earth. Could they have chosen to take a photo without any water in it? Yes, there are so many deserts on Earth. So the presence of water pools is intentional. They want people to know that this is not a photograph of Mars. And here you can see the terrain seems to be quite rocky, lots of rocks there, yet there are several spots further back that seem to be smooth, not rocky, and bluish, which would indicate that there's actually water on the ground. But there's no water on Mars, so this image can only have been taken on Earth, not on Mars. It seems that ever since the first moon landing, NASA has been faking things and making it obvious that they are faking things. Why? It makes sense that the actual missions run by NASA propaganda, which would make people think that they are slowly going out to explore space, whilst in the meantime, the true state of advancement may be many years ahead, but the true exploration is carried out by the secret space program, whilst NASA just pretends, and thus all the money for its missions goes into constructing sets and paying actors. But then, why disclose that fact? Why is the acting so bad? Why did no one construct a blast crater under the moon lander in order to make it seem more real? I don't think it is possible that they did not think of it. It was done on purpose in order to disclose the truth. They are disclosing the truth for a reason. And here you see an SDO image where you can see one of the Planet X system stellar cores inside the sun's corona, making a gravitational connection with the sun. And this is part of disclosure as well. The fact that we have been allowed to see these objects in the sun's corona is part of disclosure that is obviously wanted. SDO images showing a Planet X system stellar core in the sun's corona are obviously also purposely leaked. There's no reason for these images ever having gotten to the public unless someone desired the public to know the truth. At least someone wanted part of the public to know the truth, as it is not the whole population who gets to see or understand the truth. It is a few. But we do not have to stop here either, for it has become obvious that millions of people now know about several other things which amount to crimes against humanity. Chemtrails, fluoride in the water, mercury in vaccines, medications that kill instead of heal, GMO foods, nuclear weapons tests, substituting our money for paper and thus stealing the true wealth of nations. These too have been disclosures. Why were these crimes allowed in our world? They were allowed because the being who is ruling this world, Lucifer, influenced his minions into doing these things. Through their Luciferian religion, he ordered them to do it. He made sure they made the most horrible things to human beings that anyone can imagine, and made sure that they gained power and wealth by running a health, pharmaceutical, and energy generation system that did no good to any living organism on Earth. He made sure they found out how to create weather disasters and earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. They learned from the alien technology he gave them to control the Planet X system objects, and they learned how to hide their efforts and the objects, as well as the fact that the sun went dark as a result of the Planet X system, from the population. And you may look at Article 487 entitled Can Planet X Be Under Intelligent Control for more details. This group of people are often called the elites or the cabal. These are the group of people that have been running the planet under Lucifer for many centuries. They are the current world order. It then influenced another group of people to turn against the current world order people. These people saw what they were doing to the planet, decided that they were going to change it. These people want to bring in free energy and want the cabal to pay for their crimes. They want to stop all the crimes against humanity that the cabal has carried out and continues to carry out to this day, making things worse and worse and even setting things up to create a third world war. These are good sentiments, aren't they? Yes, they are. There's only one problem. They have been influenced by the same being who caused all the crimes against humanity in the first place. And Lucifer comes only to kill, steal, and destroy. He has no good intentions. He has decided to betray his minions that have served him for one good reason. This new faction, which many call the Alliance, are no more than his pawns. What does Lucifer want? He wants to fake the tribulation and the millennium reign of Christ. He wants people to think that we are now in the tribulation. He wants to end this time with a huge nuclear war, which destroys the current superpowers and a huge number of the world's population. And then he wants to start anew with a new set of rules, all the problems that he has created solved. Free energy, everyone has a job, money based on precious metals, no more fluoride in water, no more mercury in vaccines, no more GMO foods, no more chemtrails, just a good simulation system for the sun, moon, and planets, which people know about, etc. He wants people to think they are in the millennium with all the problems now solved. There is only one little thing you have to give up to get all these wonderful things. You have to give up your soul. Oh, he will not put it that way. He is very subtle. He will, through his chosen leader, the Antichrist, who may arrive on an alien spacecraft, explain that it simply means giving up your privacy. You need to be implanted with a chip so that they can monitor you. But that chip will connect your consciousness to AI, which will from then on make all your choices for you. You will no longer have free will. And you may look at Article 476 and titled Truth, the Big Bang Model, and AI is God. And of course, there is disclosure through movies, and a movie called Arrival seems to detail how the Antichrist may arrive on the scene. Thus, the reason for disclosure is because things have to be set up for the greatest deception Lucifer has ever created. That is his talent. He is a master deceiver. Jesus called him the father of lies in John 8 verse 44. He has been deceiving the human race for thousands of years, and he is about to do the final and the worst of all deceptions. There are only two factions in the universe. There is the one true God, creator of the universe, and there is Lucifer. And if factions that may become apparent on Earth, such as Russia and China against the US, that is only Lucifer pulling the strings on both sides. It will be no different with the alliance. They may think they are doing the right thing, but Lucifer is pulling the strings to bring about his own end. However, Lucifer can only do what God allows, and God is going to allow this final deception because humanity has rejected God, who is the only protection we have against Lucifer. He is going to allow this great deception, or strong delusion, or big lie, to take place. For it reads in 2 Thessalonians 2, verse 9 to 12, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, that they all might be damned who believe not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness. In conclusion, it is good that disclosure is occurring, as through it and through the true God's guidance, we have managed to find out what is going on in the solar system, what has happened to the sun, and what is going on this planet. With regard to the Planet X system, there is, however, a reason for this disclosure, and what it is leading to in the end is not good for the human beings who will be alive on this earth in the final 7 years before the real millennium reign of Christ begins. And these are the references. This is Dr. Claudia Albers, Planet X physicist. Thank you for watching.